Today is launching day. You made it. Got a project style thing, looks great.
It's a big day in Karen Grand's 8th grade technology class at Integrated Arts and Technology in the Rochester School District. Students have learned how to build air skimmers, a paper vehicle of sorts that, if successfully built and launched, will glide across the classroom's floor. Grand said a lot of work led up to launching day.
It involved a whole unit on aerospace engineering and the basic concepts around flight. And then we used our measuring skills to create a prototype according to the engineering design process. Okay. And today we are going to launch them to see if their prototypes are successful.
The students made their skimmers using simple materials: cardstock, glue, tape, scissors, a ruler, and a paperclip. But they also had another resource, John Kriegel, a retired mechanical engineer and president of the Rochester Engineering Society. Through that group, he leads a program called STEM Bridges, where volunteers help students learn about STEM topics. Kriegel has been coming to Grant's classroom at least once a week since October. His presence has made a big difference, she said.
The children have really come to look forward to John being in the classroom. They will ask, "Is John coming today?" Which I think is very welcoming. He brings the added piece to our projects and to learning. He takes it one step further because he has so much more engineering experience than I do.
Zari Campbell, an 8th grader in Grant's class, loves having Kriegel in the classroom.
Since John came, the class has been like so much more fun than before. We're doing like more projects now, and like he's like just showing us some like cool types of ways to use science at home, and it's been really fun.
Classmate Melody Confessor agreed.
He's like really, really nice man, and having me every day would, you know, make the whole class seem more fun.
That fun factor is apparent as students line up to test their skimmers. There are lots of hits and a fair share of misses too. But Kriegel and Gran use even the failed launches to teach a lesson.
All right, you know what? Let's try a rubber band. Okay, so we have to think again. Thinking out of the box, like engineers do.
This isn't Kriegel's first time in front of a classroom. He was working at Kodak in the 1990s when he took part in the company's 21st Century Learning Challenge, a STEM-based volunteer program that at its peak had 1,500 engineers and technicians in city classrooms.
We did that for 10 years. They visited twice a week. They spent 2 hours at each visit. It's a STEM initiative before the STEM acronym at a scale we haven't matched since, I think, anywhere in the world.
Kriegel knows how valuable that program was for everybody involved. So when he retired in 2012, he set his sights on a reboot of sorts. Through his work with the Rochester Engineering Society, STEM Bridges is coming to life. He has 40 interested volunteers and is hoping for many more.
I just want to try and resurrect that effort and broaden it from just Rochester City Schools to any school district that's interested, and broaden it from just engineers and technicians to anybody that has a STEM-based background. Come on, let's get back to work.
The experience, he says, is incredibly rewarding.
Watching a kid understand what density means, having the whole class get quiet when it finally soaks in, is a religious experience. I can't resist.
For the Innovation Trail, I'm Denise Young, WXXI News.